Let me get started. My name is Dr. Jagdish Chaturvedi. I'm an ENT surgeon. I'm a sinus specialist. Those with allergy, give me an achi. So Tuesday, Thursday, Fortis Hospital, Banagatta Road. Take an appointment and come. I'm a very affordable doctor. 1,000 rupees only consultation. Everyone laughs. I don't know why. But patients pay 1,000 rupees. You know why patients pay 1,000 rupees for me? Because of my name, Jagdish Chaturvedi. This guy must be like born old fellow, must have learned a lot. You know, and they think like a lot of expectations they have when they hear Jagdish Chaturvedi. They're like, okay, this doctor must be knowing everything. They come into my OPD chamber, they see me, baby face. They're like, where is Dr. Chaturvedi? I'm like, I am only Dr. Chaturvedi. Sister, in Dr. Chaturvedi room, what Varun Gandhi is doing? I know, I always say that other people beat me up. Even younger crowd, I say fat Imran Hashmi. Music lovers, I say Himesh Reshammiya. All famous people look like this only. Dangerous people, you know. Okay. How many people under the age of 30? Give me a cheer, just to understand. Under the age of 30, give me a cheer. Whole energy is gone, no? Okay, one more time. Under the age of 30, give me a loud cheer. That's a sound of denial. Married people, give me a cheer. That's the sound of pain. I'm over the age of 30 and I'm married, so I have all pain everywhere. I am having a disconnect with the youngsters nowadays. I can't connect to the youngsters. I never thought at 35 years of age, I will have generation gap. Because of the technology and all, no? The youngsters, the way they are coming, I don't know how they are wired. You know, like, I don't understand. Bro, what's up, bro? Bro, what, bro? That's how they talk. You know, they are talking like this. Somebody's behind me, I'm like, who is it? Bro, I, bro. Hey, what happened to your eyebrow? Bro, I, bro. Who's with you? Bro, bro, bro. Three bros. And it makes sense. And you know, like, I'm from the 90s, I grew up in the 90s, 80s. If someone goes to do a show, like if I go for a stand-up comedy or a show, how nicely we used to encourage people. Hey, do well, macha, do well. Break a leg. Today's generation, kill it, bro. Destroy it, bro. Like, what am I going to do there, you know? Like, and I get carried away. I don't want the generation gap. One day I did surgery, my boss asked, Jagdish, how was the surgery? Bro, killed it, bro. Destroyed it, bro. He wanted to kill and destroy me after that. We can't do that to the patient. No, sir, I'm chikkappa mele surgery maadta inge to kittag bittidini vardag bittidini size bittidwa. We can't do like that. If we do that, they will come after. That's why patients beat doctors nowadays. That's why I'm doing comedy, for security reasons. One backup we need. Yeah, it's tough nowadays. It's very tough to do practice nowadays, I must tell. Like, everything is changing, you know. Recently, like few days back, you know, one patient came to my chamber, brought his mother, and he's like, doctor, make ready and give means 5 o'clock delivery, give home. I'm like, auto spare part, huh? I'm like, yeah, mia bill lako hai kya, you know. Expectations are changing, you know. Very tough. And now there's a lot of online practice because of this technology. Have you seen? Online practice, very confusing nowadays to do online practice. I had a patient named Shweta who wanted to prepone the appointment from 6:30 to, she wanted to postpone from 6:30 to 7 o'clock. I'm like, sure, Shweta, you are my only patient. You come at 7 o'clock, I will leave accordingly from home. In 3 days, I'm waiting for you only. She responds back with 2 kisses. One hug. 3 smileys. I'm like, what happened? I see my over smartphone auto-corrected Shweta to sweetheart. Like, you never know whether it's a consultation or dating nowadays. Very, very confusing. I was a bad child. How many of you have gone to school? Give me a cheer. Of course, you're all teachers. Yeah, I was a very bad school student, you know. Like, any backbenchers? Give me a cheer. Backbenchers? Okay. Some have promoted themselves. Some have demoted themselves. All of you are teachers. I have a lot of respect for you. And I thought I'll talk about a bit about teachers today. And look, this is all mistakes I made in childhood, okay? So pardon anything. Because when you are a child, you don't know what mistakes you make, right? So I am that child in the class. If you have noticed that when the teacher is like this, I'll be the one make the sound. Who's that, I say? Who did that? What you ate and came? You know, and then again, don't do like that. And then a teacher turns and I'll be like, pss, 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 pss. Hey, who's talking behind my back? Who's talking behind my back, nonsense fellow? And then when they turn around, I'm the one who'll ask the doubt. It's like, madam, we are not talking behind your back. We are talking in front of your back. Because see, madam, your back is in front of us. You should say, I don't like people talking in front of my back or behind my front. She was the English teacher. So she gave me a compliment. Outstanding. And then the teachers made a pact. It's like, you know, this student, Jagdish Chaturvedi, I first thought he was a teacher. He's sitting at the back. He disturbs us in the class. We have to do something. And you know how teachers are, right? Like they know how to train these guys. You know, the one teacher said, let's embarrass him publicly. Annual day function. Let him talk in front of 1,000 people. He'll get sense. And they're like, okay. Sixth standard child, they put me on stage, parent-teacher meeting, I mean that annual day function, 1,000 families. Okay. And they made me the MC, master of ceremony, right? And in front of 1,000 people, I'm supposed to introduce some very important chief guest. There was an IAS officer and his wife. Now, I had this very basic confusion, guys. What is the female of lion? What is the female of tiger? What is the female of mister? What you said means pati, patni or war. This means war. I mean, I was saying lion, lioness, tiger, tigress. Gives me great pleasure to announce on stage a very important chief guest, Mr. Range Gowda and his mistress Raj Lakshmi. In front of 1,000 people, you know, I didn't stop there. I was like, yes, mistress, what do you want, mistress? You want water, mistress? What was audience was like, yeah, this, what is this guy saying? Like, he's given a bad word. There was an elderly lady. She was shouting at the top of her voice when I went down. She was very upset. She was the headmistress. I got even more confused. I'm like, you are the head of mistresses. Why are you getting angry if I'm talking? I'm giving the same respect. I had to apologize because, you know, she was big. I was small. Next annual day function, I realized I was correct. Mr. Range Gowda never came back with Raj Lakshmi after that. He came back with Vijay Lakshmi. It's victory for him, you know. Somehow I was very bad at mathematics and I became a doctor. Anybody from Tumkur here? Tumkur? A few people from Tumkur. I studied in Tumkur, Siddhartha Medical College. I did my internship in the district hospital there. Everyone knew this guy makes a lot of mistakes. Be careful. And can you guess for someone who makes so many mistakes, what is the first posting they gave me? Obstetrics and gynecology. 1st of May, literally Labor Day for me. District surgeon knew we should be careful with this fellow. They gave a senior nurse to supervise me. The nurse name was Narsamma. Name changed. This lady whom I was supposed to deliver, her name was Garbhamma. Name changed. Now, I didn't understand one thing, even though I'm born and raised in Bangalore. Every time Garbhamma goes into a contraction, Narsamma would do, Mukkamma, Mukkamma. What is wrong with you? What is this Mukka Mukka? I'm focusing. Again, baby goes, Garbhamma goes into contraction, Narsamma is like, Mukkamma, Mukkamma. I should treat you, I should treat her. What is wrong with you? Then so contagious it was, she was doing Mukkamma, Mukkamma. Garbhamma started doing Mukkamma, Mukkamma. I started doing Mukkamma, Mukkamma. Whole world is doing Mukkamma. I get confused, I go to the labor waiting area. I'm like, Mukkamma, ellidira. They're calling you over here. Narsamma like, doctor, so cute, doctor. Varun Gandhi. Baby face. Doctor, Mukkamma in Kannada means push. Oh, Pushpamma, Pushpamma. I was removed from that posting because Pushpamma's husband was looking for me. His name was Gundappa. I didn't take any chances. I was removed from that posting. I was put into psychiatry, not as a doctor, as a patient. And then they moved me to general medicine. I went into general medicine, you know. And you know, we study a lot, right, to become a doctor. You know, like almost, like normal person takes 5.5 years to study. But who are very passionate about the subject like me, I took 8 to 9 years to study. I know you are judging me. What is wrong in that? Like, see, if you like something, you do it multiple times. I like biochemistry a lot. It didn't want to leave me. You know, like you watch a movie, you like it, you watch it 8-10 times, right? Yeah, I like microbiology very much. 8-10 years after that, I'm supposed to see a patient, right? And we fantasize how our first patient will be. All this knowledge has to download on that first patient. Will it be a male, female, elderly, young child? What will it be? I am in a medicine posting. They wheel me. They take me from the back entrance of the, you know, OPD chamber. And one compounder is only worried about, sir, root aita. I'm like, how do, sir? Aita nimda aita? Aito. Okay, very good. Sir, you've eaten well, no? I'm like, yeah. I'm like, why? I'm sitting. I'm ready for my first patient. And in that room, no, there are two doors. And something heavy is there behind both the doors. And he says, sir, ready? I'm like, yeah. And unleashes 100 people inside. Together at the same time, talking. Sir, BP not sir, BP sir, sir, sugar sir, BP sugar sir, aha, sir, what now, sir, all together. I felt like a celebrity for the beginning. Then I got scared. So then I thought, like, you know, I will spend a lot of time, I will give all my diagnosis. Now I am in crowd control mode. If they say pain, paracetamol. Fever, anti-fever medicine. Don't know what to do, send for test. We will figure out later on. We're reading on the wall, some drug company people have written, oh, we can give that. Huh? That makes them drowsy. Hey, tagoda pai. Go sleep somewhere. You know, like 100 people. And I used to think, you know, as a doctor, what is this? Like, you know how many doctor to patient ratio we have in our country? We have one doctor for 1,700 people. It is not bad at all. World Health Organization says you should have one doctor for 1,000 people. We are just 700 people behind. It's not that bad. But what happens when most of the doctors want to go abroad to get an American accent or only locate themselves in cities? What happens the moment you go to the periphery? You have one doctor for 10,000, 15,000 people. And that is the situation over here that I was having, right? Somehow I became a postgraduate student. I was at St. John's Medical College. I got into ENT with a lot of difficulty. Studied for many years. When I went into ENT, you know, we have all these things. You have to see a lot of patients, ward work and all of that. And we used to go to a rural area called Mugloor. Anybody been to Mugloor towards way to Anikal? It's a very nice primary healthcare center. And Igloor, Mugloor. No Mugloor? That whole town lied to me for so many years. Everyone saying, sir, we are from Mugloor. Illa Paigloor, you don't know. I don't know. I mean, like maybe like all of those are 10, 15,000 people. They had printed Mugloor also. I was like, okay, let us just, you may be spelling mistake, ma'am. It can happen. Maybe they are E-Mugloor. Virtually, they are there and M is silent. You know, like, so well, I don't know, but whatever. One of those places I used to go and we used to see patients with throat problems. You know, even today, 2016, 2015, how people see patients with throat problems. Okay, first we have to make the patient sit and we have to hold the tongue with our bare hand. And you can smell the manikchand. You literally say, ah, zuba kesari, wah. What a kesari zuban you have. And then with that wiggly hand, you put the mirror. Small mirror goes at the back. It is fogging with every breath. Okay, in that fog, manikchand is giving me kick. And in that fog, you're supposed to quickly look at the vocal cord by a reflection of the light. Behind my shoulder, the light will go. It will hit the right tangent, go, and it will visualize the vocal cord. It's easier to see the moon on Karwa Chauth than to see the vocal cord like this. In that microsecond, I have to make a diagnosis. And I am not understanding anything. But we have seniors, and my senior wanted to rag me. So he is seeing another patient, and he's like, Jagdish, come here. Tell me your findings. I again hold. This guy had Manikchand also. I put another mirror. And then my friends told me, Jagdish, when every senior asks you a question, tell them the most safest answer. I told, he is normal. Because somehow God takes care of all diseases. My seniors are like, thank God you could make out something. I couldn't make out anything myself. And that is where fear gripped me the first time. That neither he nor I know what is going on. We dress up nicely, suit boot. We travel 80 kilometers to Mugloor. Patient leaves his daily wage, comes from the farm. And they are expecting us to find something. We are playing dandiya inside. We are not understanding anything. And you know what Swadesh had recently released? So I was in full Shah Rukh Khan mode. I was like, I should do something for the country. You know, and I should do something. So I did something unthinkable, which most people will not do. I went to my boss, the HOD. He was, you know, the teacher guru, senior person. Very angry. All of us have angry bosses sometime or the other in our life, right? He was a very angry person known for his anger. Okay. I go to him at the end of his OPD. I'm like, sir, we go to some remote area. We are trying to see mirror, vocal cords, not able to make out. There the patient needs to be identified early. Here in St. John's, where there is a 10 lakh rupee endoscopy equipment, 3-chip camera, you can see the cancer from outside. What is the use of this? Why don't we have this over there and see patients like this over here? And he's like, and he asked me a question, Jagdish, are you a barking dog or biting dog? I'm like, out of syllabus question. But I knew barking dog is not good. I said, sir, I am a biting dog. Why are you barking? This is what I hear. Why this is not there? Why that is not there? Why this is not there? I'm like, if you are a biting dog, do something about it. So I was like, what can I do, sir? A salary 9,000 rupees. Postgraduate student. He's like, no, you want to do something, you make a prototype, you do something about it. And I had an idea, you know what I did? I didn't have any money, but we are blessed with Indian parents, you know. And Indian parents will give money if you can nicely move your lower chin like this. It's an art you have to practice for many hours. Go in front of the mirror and do. They'll be like, what do you want, son? Like, sir, papa, 1 lakh. 1 lakh or 1 lakh, what do you want? Like, one project is there, I want to do something. So I took some money from my parents. I bought a digital camera. Phones were not very popular that time, smartphones. And I took an endoscope. And I got a mechanical engineer to attach the two. Right? And took the light source from the machine of the camera and attached to the endoscope. Okay. And I was amazed. Because next time when I went to Mugloor, I was putting a 90 degree video endoscope into the throat, seeing the video on the camera, recording it and showing the patient, not a pa. And you should see, this is the patient's reaction. Sir, what is that white thing? Is that dangerous, sir? And you know, he became so compliant, for the next 1 week, he's calling and coming. Sir, when are you coming? I want to see camera. Is it there? It is not there. Compliance changed. The way they respond to medicines changed. Everything changed. And I was amazed. I was like, wow, this is a handheld portable device. I went to Dr. Ravi Nair. My boss's name was Dr. Ravi Nair. I went to him. I'm like, sir, see, I made a bite. He looks at me and says, Jagdish, if you had not done anything, I would have forgiven you. Now you have made something. You are not passing before making this device. I'm like, a PG student, sir, you are my thesis guide. Why don't I make one device for you? Both of us will live happily ever after. This is also working nice only. He's like, no, it's a prototype. You drop it, it'll break. You can do good. A lot of people can get this diagnosis. If you leave this now, it is a big crime. If you hadn't worked on it, it was fine. I'm like, sir, what do I do? He's like, you need to form a company. I will give you leave. All my colleagues are like, I have to do his duty now. Because extra work for them. And I was like, how do I find a co-founder? I go home. I had a wife. So I asked my wife, you are my partner in life. You want to start a company with me? She says, no. So I asked the next best option, her sister. She agreed. She was from IIT Chennai, did some aeronautical engineering. She was jobless. She was like, I'll form the company with you. I'll also get some company. Both of us form a company. We try to make this endoscope thing. Worst decision of my life, running from here to there. Nobody wants to invest in us. They're like, you are a part-time doctor. I'm not putting my money in you. My horse, if I put money, has to run all the time. You can't see patients in between. And horrible. We had a design team. We were paying the design team out of our pocket. And all our money got exhausted very soon. And I went to Dr. Ravina. I'm like, boss, literally, I really tried. I want to pass. I want to be an ENT surgeon, normal guy. I can't do this. We don't know how to invent as doctors. Please, Devit to Shamisi, let us go. Ravina is like, okay, cool, no problem. You tried, so it's fine. But just before I was leaving, he's like, Jagdish, if we don't know how to invent, someone must be knowing. I'm like, yes, correct. Why don't you learn from them? But where I'll find someone? He found a fellowship program run by the government of India called Stanford India Biodesign Program. It's a unique program. I must congratulate the government for having a program like that. They take one doctor from the entire country, club with a scientist, designer, business person, send them to US to Stanford University to learn how to invent. Come back to India, apply that. Right? And you know how much they spend per fellow? 1 crore rupees per fellow. Okay. And Dr. Ravi Nair said, if you get into that fellowship, I'll clear you. And I somehow got into that fellowship in 2012. And I got, and he is like, okay, I'll pass you. Listen, thank you. I was like, what do I do with the device? How many of you have seen Godfather? I called the design team and I gave them an offer they could not refuse. I said, boss, I have no money. This is a great device. I sell it to you. And I didn't know about business, so I sold it for a ridiculous term. They were like, good device doctor is giving to us. We'll just, you know, make him sign some small royalty and we'll take it over. And I went to Stanford University. And all four of us from Bangalore and Delhi and all of that, we went to Stanford like Lord of the Rings, okay, to learn how to invent devices. And there I got three shocks of my life. First shock was, the people who were teaching us how to invent in Stanford were doctors from India with American accents. Raj Doshi, Ujay Kumar, Anurag Mehral. I'm like, we came from seven oceans spending 1 crore. At least give us some George or Andrew, man. Like, some Jessica, something. What do I tell going back? I learned from Raj Doshi. You know, the American accent. I'm like, and I'm asking this the guy, you know, he's a cardiologist. Cardiologists are teaching how to invent. We are importing it at 10 times the cost. I'm like, boss, what is the difference between you and I? Where did you do your MBBS from? Cat Copper, Mumbai. Like a Ghat Copper, Mumbai. I have not even heard of your medical college. I am coming all the way with so many ummids, some Paul, someone will be like, who's this guy? I'm like, how did you get into this? It's like, yeah, I was a mechanical engineer. I got bored of it, so I became a cardiologist. You what? You got bored of mechanical engineering? You became cardiologist? How do you become a cardiologist? We tried 20 years, we only become losers. How do you become? I didn't like it. I like the mechanics of the heart. I became a cardiologist. Then I thought, let me invent devices. I'm like, what are you talking about? Like, I was in full, like, 3-4 days. I didn't understand what is happening here. Third shock. When they invent, they don't think of idea. I'm like, then how do you invent? Their style of invention is very different. See, Indians were very passionate. When we have an idea, it's like falling in love. Oh, yeah. Idea has come. I have solved the world problem in my head. Now the question is how to make it. No question of correcting the idea. I know what the problem is. I have solved it in my head. I am now going to solve it. Will you make it? Right? Those guys are opposite. They don't think of the idea. What they do is they take a doctor, engineer, designer, scientist, send them to hospital, observe for 6 months. 6 months, just observe. We are standing like perverts. We're like, they like, keep observing, don't blink your eye. We're going on observing, you know. Some people got very afraid also from us. You know, and observe for problems. When you see something problem, make a note of it. Ah, problem. Then think of solution. No, don't think of solution. Park the solution somewhere. Like, we don't find parking in Bangalore, sir. I come from a place where nothing called parking exists. It's an illusion. Okay, and I park that idea at the back. Keep looking at problems. 6 months, we're looking at problems. My house problems look less problematic. Full of problems we are documenting, and then you do some major scientific research on each problem, what is the incidence, prevalence, volume, data, market, business, and then you come to know which is the most important problem. Then you open the Bible on the problem, why this problem occurred, why it didn't occur, how. After everything, the solution is obvious. Then they think of the idea. I was like, oh, this is the way you guys invent. So I came to India, I told nobody falls in love. We will do systematic way. We were in Delhi at All India Institute of Medical Sciences. I said, everyone keep observing. While sleeping also, our eyes are open because we're observing. Women in Delhi are scared of us. They're like, kya dekh raha hai? I'm like, I'm seeing if you have any unmet needs. Almost got beaten up because of the observation problem and all. But you know, we learned how to invent. And then that is when I realized, you know, I was doing something fundamentally wrong in my first device, because that was a device out of love. You know, I just thought of it. And I thought to make it. And that company was like, hey, boss, you sold us this device. Nobody wants to buy it. I'm like, why? It's such a good device, good technology. Then I realized from this whole process that I did not do any research. I just, as an ENT surgeon, thought I can't see the vocal cords. Put a camera, see the vocal cord. I went in with my team and did research for 6 months and realized what we invented was absolutely foolish. I'll tell you why. I made a handheld digital video endoscopy device for rural area. Who will use endoscopy devices? ENT surgeons. We take 3 to 5 years to learn how to do endoscopy. Rural areas, how many ENT surgeons are there? 11. Who will use this? Will you give an MBBS doctor an endoscopy? there is a huge chance of injury. That is the fundamental flaw in that whole technology. All we had to do is redesign it so that the most low-skilled person, like a health worker, could use it. We redesigned the device, health worker could use it, 7th standard pass housewife. Within 6 months, product sold to a large company called Medtronic. And today, 10,000 health workers have been trained, 500,000 patients have been screened, and 100,000 patients have been operated. Simple change in mindset is like, don't fall in love with your idea, understand the problem. You understand the problem, solution is obvious. And that, after that, you know, when you did that copy pasting, you know, I'm very good at copy pasting from school days itself. We just copy pasted that, created multiple teams of doctor, engineer, designer, scientists, came up with multiple companies, and we have 7 products in the market now. We're able to develop between 2.5 to 3 years. But since this was a conference on teachers, I really wanted to, in an open platform, thank my teacher, Dr. Ravi Nair, because if it wasn't the guru who called me a barking dog or biting dog, I wouldn't be what I am today. So big round of applause for Dr. Ravi Nair and all of you, because you create people like us. And I thought there's no other better platform to share this. But I thought, let me end in a little humorous note. How many of you love Bangalore traffic? Give me a cheer. Why, sir? What is Bangalore famous for? See how the mindset is changing. Gardens, we're Garden City. What happened to the Garden City, you know? I think, you know, Bangalore traffic is becoming like, it's going to be taken over by the Archaeological Survey of India, you know? It's like, it's a sightseeing thing. People come from all over the country to see Bangalore traffic. That's why there is Bangalore traffic. And the Uber drivers, they're like guides. Sir, noddy, sir, this is a very congested traffic area since 1995. We call it Marathali Bridge. 2 days later, we will reach another very popular area called Tin Factory. And we will sleep for 5 days in Silkport Junction. That is where I will give you shaving kit. If you don't have foam, we will go to Belundur Lake. It produces foam. And aftershave also. You know? Then in 4 hours, we will reach the airport. From there, half an hour, you can reach anywhere in the country. You know, it's like that. I think Bangalore traffic has really helped me a lot, because I was a very angry person. And Bangalore traffic has helped me tame my anger. Really control the anger. You know, nice. You get angry, you control it. It's very nice. You know, I was once on the right side of the road in a car. I wanted to go on the left as usual. And there was another guy on the left side of the road who wanted to go on right as usual. And somewhere between, we met. Classical thing happens, both car park on the left. And people appear. Something will happen, fight will happen live. And you know, I am a performer, I am doing theater since the age of 7. If I get an audience, I have to perform. They will get disappointed. I have to get into character. Even if I am not angry, I have to fight. What will they think? So I started researching traffic anger. And I realized there are many different types of anger. Like the most common type of anger I have seen outside is the animal kind of anger. Have you seen this animal kind of anger? It's very nice. It's like this. Hey! Hey! Hey, yeah, huh? Hey! To this you can't say, tell me, sir, what you want. You have to respond in the same language. Yeah, no? Yeah. Hey, yeah, kabai, nini kabai. Hey, nini kabai. Hey, hey, hey. Like mating calls. Audience is also like, kya, what is happening? Wow. Full language is happening. The other thing I've noticed is married people never get angry in road traffic accident. Yeah, they never get angry. You can tell a married man, he'll come out of the car, he'll close the door. It's like an insurance paper. Call the traffic cop. I have a lot of problems at home. I don't want one more problem here. Anyone from Delhi here? Delhi people? Very safe environment. People from Delhi have a very strange medical condition when they get angry. They have sudden onset amnesia, memory loss, dementia, Alzheimer's. They forget everything and they look at you and say, "Tu janta hai main kaun hu?" "Tu janta hai mera baap kaun hai?" "Kaun hai mera baap waise? Kaun hai? Kaun hai? Tu kaun hai be? Tu kaun hai? Tu kaun hai janta hai mera baap kaun hai? Abhi ye kya hai? What are you saying? Abhi ye kya hai? Ye kaise chalta hai?" And they'll tell the police, "I don't know what happened, sir. My driver, I don't know what is this." Full memory loss. Haryana, Gurgaon people, next level. Anybody from Gurgaon, Haryana here? They like to challenge. "Haath laga ke dikha."
ओ मरने हाथ लगा के दिखा तो सही.
ओके एंड देन वन हैंड विल बी बिहाइंड. ओके टच एंड शो एंड दे विल नेवर डू दैट अलोन. देयर फ्रेंड्स विल बी देयर. हाथ लगा के तो छोड़ना नहीं, पे छोड़ना नहीं, हाथ लगा ए डोंट लिफ्ट ए हाथ लगा. सो आई वॉज इन दिस कार एक्सीडेंट. नोबडी केम आउट टू फाइट. आई थॉट मे बी देयर फ्रॉम लखनऊ प्लेइंग पहले आप you know they are sitting in the car and they're like huzur aap. I'm like nahi huzur aap. Huzur aap farmaiye. It's like nahi main farmata hu aap farmaiye. You know we're doing that and then I thought okay maybe I should only go because Bangalore is a little more courteous. You know like okay we'll help our guests. Come I'll come and fight with you. I come to the car and I see that this is the kind of person I have never fought with in road traffic accident. It was a woman driver. Now guys in 2018 if you have a fight with a woman driver in road traffic accident, it's a very serious problem. Because anything you do, you will be labeled something. Like if I make fun of her driving, I'll be called a sexist. If I scold her, I'm a misogynist. If I get scolded by her, I'm a masochist. If I call the male traffic cop, I'm promoting the patriarchal society. If I go away, it's hit and run case. If I don't do anything, I'm a sapiosexual. I don't know what it is, but I become something. And this girl looks at me. She looks like this. She rolls down the window. She applies lipstick. She combs her hair. And she takes her head out and looks at me and says,
Bhaiya, Shule Circle kidhar aata hai? Mera map kaam nahi kar raha hai Shule Circle.
I'm like, she didn't know the car was it. You go front, ma. Go there and keep circling around. By the time I leave... Oh, buddy, I was like, I survived. Otherwise, next day the news will be like, sexist doctor abuses female driver. My three patients, they will also go away. One of them was Shweta. She's coming regularly. But after that, I don't drive. I take cab and come. Like, we leave it on the Uber wala. But my car stopped working, you know, because the car was hit, okay. So, car stopped working. And in Bangalore, nobody has patience, okay. I was like, hey, thagyo pa gaadi. I'm like, sir, it is not working. Hey, thagyo, working. Hey, not working. I put on that flashlight also, that hazard light. Nobody understands the hazard light. I'm like, sir, I put light. Hey, light is working. Move the car, I said. Sir, it is not working, sir. It is blocked, sir. It's like, hey, thagyo pa gaadi. What hazard light? What azadi is this? Huh? What azadi? And they're coming to beat me. I'm acting like Delhi fellow. Hey, kiska gaadi hai ye? कौन छोड़ा रे इसको इधर. आई डोंट नो हु दिस इज. तू जानता ही किसका मैं कौन हूं कौन है. यू नो एंड आई एम लाइक हाउ डू आई गेट आउट ऑफ दिस सिचुएशन. पीपल विल बीट मी अप एंड देन आई गो टू द साइड. आई एम जस्ट वेटिंग नियर द ट्री एंड आई लुक अप एंड आई एम लाइक आई गेट एन आइडिया. आई ब्रेक अ ब्रांच ऑफ द ट्री एंड आई शव इट इन द कार. एवरीबडी अंडरस्टूड द कार इज सो ब्रोकन डाउन. इट्स ग्रोइंग ट्रीज मस्ट बी ब्रोकन. Thank you very much, everyone. You've been a wonderful audience. Thank you. Wait. I don't get so many claps. Let me just take a video of this also. Okay. Would you be so kind to clap once more? Thank you very much, guys. You've been a wonderful audience. Thank you. Oh, wow. So sweet of you. Thank you.